Heyo everybody, Haku here with my live reaction to the Beastars anime opening. So this one has been a video a long time coming. I've been working forever to like get this new setup going so that I could record on this and not have to worry about the video lagging like crazy with the like what happened with the Boku no Hero Academia opening reaction. But for those of you who don't know, Beastars is my favorite manga, and it has been. I've been preaching it for a while, probably almost a year now. Or even longer, maybe. But I love Beastars, and I'm so excited for the anime. So it's been difficult. It's been very, very difficult to just hold back and not look at anything to do with the opening, because I also absolutely love anime openings. So going into this, I do know that there's going to be some level of like stop motion or something like that, just because I follow the Studio Orange Twitter account and everything, but I've avoided seeing any of the visuals. Now the song, I heard some of it in the PVs and the little scrolly credits at the end of the first episode, but I haven't, like, unless that's everything that's in the part that we're seeing here for the opening, that's just the extent of things that I've seen. But I didn't really give a bunch of thought to where or how I was recording, so the background kind of has a lot going on right now. But either way, let's react to this. I'm super excited. And then afterward, we can talk about it a bit. But either way, let's get into this. I'm just so excited. I almost broke yesterday and watched, but I didn't. So let's do this. Oh, I finally get to. This intro, when we heard it before, it reminds me of the Bakano opening. It's really interesting. Sorry, I'm just trying to hear the song. Oh, Haru, so adorable. Oh, I love it. And the way it's in Louis's antlers. Or Louis. Louis's? I like this a lot. The music still, I just keep thinking of the Bakano opening. I love the fountain effect. This is really good. Oh, I just got chills. Oh my god, I'm so happy. Who would have thought we would ever be getting this? I love it. I like the creativity of using the stop motion too. Ah, oh, that's really good. We saw the skull and everything, the red moon, like from the first episode. Okay, that was really good. I like that a lot. It was really, really creative. And that's something that I was talking about when I reviewed the first episode. I like how there are just so many chances taken and so many things done very, very differently with this. There are a few things I heard, but I didn't do like super duper research on or anything. Like, say, about, I think that the Studio Orange Twitter had posted that the person who was directing, or actually it was the producer for Hoseki no Kuni, way back when while that was still in production and Beastars only had a few volumes out, they said way back then, we need to be the studio that does Beastars because I want to be the one to work on Beastars. I love that story. Gosh, the series is just so, so, so good. I know they posted some behind-the-scenes things on the opening, so I might actually take a jump cut to go watch those and then cut back in and discuss more after having seen those. But yeah, just in general, I really, really liked the visuals and how creative it was. I think as a fan, there's always this thing when you're a fan of like a source material of something and it gets made into an anime, there's always this tendency to be like, oh, they could have gone harder, they could have done more. But I really like this for what it was and the focus they put on Haru and Legoshi, but still having Louis in there in a way I really, really liked. Besides that, they sort of captured some vibes from the series without really spoiling anything or trying to give anything away, which is an interesting way to do it too. Yeah, is there anything else I was thinking of before I stopped it here? No, either way, let me go watch those and I'll come back for further discussion on this, in a second, right after you see this jump cut. Okay, so actually, after going and watching all that, it was really, really cool getting to see a little bit of the storyboarding and especially some of the pieces they used to make the models and the making of the models and everything. I thought that was really, really cool. But there's not really any extra thoughts it adds to how much I enjoyed the opening or what I thought about the opening. But either way, in the comments or description or both, I'll put links to both, of course, the official place where I watched this opening and also the behind-the-scenes video so that you all can check it out yourselves. But either way, as for the future of Beastars on the channel, if you want to read the manga or read along with me, I have actually recorded my entire sort of journey through it from my first time reading chapter one all the way up until I do it weekly when new chapters are out. I'll try to keep, of course, thumbnails and stuff and titles as spoiler-free as possible, but if you're interested in any of that, I do videos on the manga weekly, and yeah, you can go back and read along with me through all of my journey reading through Beastars. But in addition to that, with the anime now starting up, I'm going to be reviewing every episode of the anime, so I'm really excited to be able to do that. And I also want to make just more Beastars discussion videos. I want to do just a general video, especially to hype the series up for new people without giving them any kind of spoilers or anything like that. Just to, hype the series up for them, tell, and, sort of for people that aren't into the series, sort of explain maybe why they should give it a chance, whether the anime or the manga. So yeah, I'm really, really excited. I'm excited and so happy for all the attention that the series has been getting, because like I said, I've loved this series for a while now. It's my favorite manga, and that's saying something with some of the other great series that I love. But yeah, I suppose that's it for this video. I'm gonna do another video on the ending, which will probably be a bit shorter because I don't think there's a behind the scenes video, and there's maybe gonna be less discussion for it. But either way, I hope you did enjoy this video, and if you did, if you did like the video, and comment down there to tell me what you thought of the opening, what you think of my thoughts, my reaction, and all that. Subscribe for more Beastars and much more on the channel so you can see when new videos come out as they come out, or follow on Twitter if you want, and I can keep you updated there and stuff for the channel or talk to you there. I always tweet out whenever I post a new video. If you want a link to our Discord server, it's free and open for anyone. We can talk about Beastars or anything else there. I have separate tabs, of course, for the Beastars manga and anime to try to keep things separate so that nobody gets spoiled, of course, because that would be terrible. I hate people getting spoiled on things. I like the excitement of people going fresh into things. But yeah, if you want a link to the Discord server, ask and I'll give you one. It is free and open for anyone, and I can just give you a link, whether you ask here in the comments or on the community tab or on Twitter, just anywhere. And also, if you want to help support the channel and help it so I can keep making videos, patreon.com/hakuofthetubes, or a link to that will be in the description. Also, patrons get to vote on a, well, get to give suggestions, and then I put the suggestions to a poll and vote on that for new series whenever I decide to add a new series. The current one I have in that slot is Assassination Classroom, so whenever we finish that or I decide to add another new series to the channel, you can give suggestions and vote on that. But yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.